Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the Rasko broke free from Mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled Mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Pat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a click of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went, hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. "Come, child, eat your fill." So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as a wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark yet regal. "Gifts we gave, but more you took," she snarled. "So more in turn is due."
Damn. By the way, we don't need to play the game anymore now, because they've just pretty much just shown you what's happened through that.
She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because she doesn't understand it, thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory. You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Then, go cautiously take your daughter to bed. I'll finish dinner.
It's okay, Rose. Your mother doesn't want to remember. I can't blame her.
Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down. Our taste in music's definitely improved over the years.
You mean mine has?
Like I said to your mom, that book's too scary for you. Why do I even keep this around? I should get rid of it someday. Gotta do a deep clean before Rose starts walking around. Almost there, honey. go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Is she okay?
Sleeping like a baby. Hmm, that smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's chorba de legum. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Hmm. Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any. You really have to stop worrying.
It's just... finding you in Louisiana, the pregnancy, Chris moving us here, military training, it all happened so fast, you know?
Well, at least we're all together. You, me, Rose. Now, everything's gonna
Seriously, think we can just forget about what happened in Louisiana?
It happened so long ago. I don't understand why you are so...
Mia, get down! Mia!
So, was she the one who had the military training, or is it me? Because that just seemed a bit...
Mia. Oh, God! Chris? What the hell?
Sorry.
What? Why?
Go move.
All clear. Rose?
What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Package secure, sir.
Take him away.
I said get your hands off her!
Ethan, no.
Rose.
Get him out.
They gone, man. They gone.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Mr. Winters. I've got your daughter's results back, and I'd like you to come in to talk about them. How about next Thursday, 4 o'clock?
No problem. We'll be there. That was the doc. She'll see us next week.
Hey, now. Think positively, all right? We talked about this.
I know. We hardly talk about anything else. I keep telling you, it's not Rose that I'm worried about.
Well, then what are you worried about? Look, she's gonna be fine. I just know it. What else matters?
We matter, Ethan! You matter! You just won't.
Mia, what are you talking about? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, talk to me.
Damn it. I have to take this.
Jesus. talking about? Where's Chris Redfield and Rose?
Who is this? This is a secure channel. You are not authorized.
Fuck. What the hell happened to you?
This whole sequence kind of feels like Evil Within. That's one dead crow. Why does it, it feels like the flashlights. Seems a bit low.
did all this?
Whatever it was, it's long gone, man. Ooh.
Maybe they're out.
Probably not. Body got dragged. He gone, man. He gone.
What happened?
Missing home.
No, friendly, who are you? Who sent you?
Nobody. There was an accident down on the road and...
What's going on?
I'm gonna have a knife, mate. I'll fuck him up. Come here.
Take it!
Cheers, mate.
Help me out.
Eagle, man. Eagle.
Shit!
Now it's my turn.
Dead body? Wait, there's more.
That's clearly the same
thing. Jesus Christ. What the hell is wrong with this place?
Great start. Nearly off man ripped off.
What the fuck was that?
Lovely.
No. Take it back.
Well, they take a lot of bullets, don't they? On hardcore.
What the hell?
Locked from the other side. That's better. It's a shame I can't pull him upside down. Oh shit. He gone, man. He gone. Don't just give me another honor. You gone. You go.
If there are any survivors out there, come to my to Louisa's house near the fields.
Survivors?
Saying there's still somewhere in this building. Was it on the other side? It's like on the other side. Shotgun already. That seems a bit. And I'm dead. Well, looks like I've got to keep doing this bit over and over again.
Is it over?
All right, boys.
Okay. Damn it.
Yeah, getting the shotgun this early just seems a bit troublesome since at least you just got to the little village. It just says survive the attack, so. I'm fucking stuck, man. Oh, okay. Well, it doesn't help that I'm playing on. Playing on hardcore. Yep. Yeah, I know, but still.
Over.
I just prefer to play on those. There you go. Yeah, I've always loved Resident Evil. It just puts me off that it's in first person though. That's why I never played 7. No, because it was in first person.
There's no end to them.
Yeah, I obviously know it now since I went on the thingy option where it tells you what happened on 7. Obviously, don't say it because obviously I do want to pay attention. Kind of feels like though that they've. It kind of feels like they've gave it away right at the beginning of the game. That at least it tells you the story at the beginning of the book. Cutscene. Yeah. It obviously means that it's the whole point of the game. You come into a village, which you are in a village, you bump into someone, and then it gives you a gift, and then it's like, she takes all the gifts, but it's been given to her, she's not actually taking it. And then, she goes to the horse, and then the horse, she just takes it, and the horse gets angry, and then she summons all the bad guys to come and kill her. And that's what it kind of feels like that this is going to be. And then a witch appears. Oh yeah, good one. So there's going to be four bosses in the fucking game. You've killed all them four bosses, and then at the end it summons one big boss.
Over.
Don't shh. Yeah, but still, don't say it. Since it's a Resident Evil game.
No end to them.
shit!
Whoa, why the fuck did he just... I just randomly just changed to my knife.
Say they're not fucking friendly on the hardest.
Is it over?
Any reason why I've brought it, it's just I want to know what's Chris doing. That's the only thing I've brought it for. Because like I said, this doesn't really wow me, because it's in first person. I've always said Resident Evil games shouldn't be in first person. It doesn't fit it whatsoever. Third person's just
okay.
Pushing it, but
Damn it. It
should always just stick at fixed camera angles. That was just so much. That's what made the game. That's what gives it the horror aspect. If you want to kill it, you have to stand still and shoot it. Not, I'll just run around and start kicking and punching and shit. Best Resident Evil game out there, Resident Evil Remake. That's the best one.
Shit! There's no end to them. Thank you.
Oh, so you can... Mate, that's the whole fucking... That's a whole different fucking ball game now, lads. Yeah, I didn't know you could fucking do that. You can fucking push him again when you fucking guard him.
You're kidding me.
Lord Sadler.